What's up?
Welcome to Pathak Yoga. My name is Basanti, and we're going to do a pregnancy video for you today. So particularly for those who are pregnant, of course, do check with your doctor or physician and don't do anything that might be harmful. So we're going to start by bringing the soles of our feet together. We're just letting the knees drop on either side of us, and then we hold on to our opposite ankle just because that helps us straighten our spine a little bit. Then we close our eyes and breathe. So a lot of pregnancy yoga is about just breathing properly. So we want to start feeling the breath, not just up here, not just up here and down there, but also in our stomach. When we're in a very tight top, you should be able to see my stomach expand and contract, and that's exactly what your stomach should do as well. Deep breaths all the way in and all the way out. Relax the hands. We can bring the hands to Dhyan Mudra. You can close your eyes. So whatever feels natural here, just start feeling your breath. Start following your breath all the way down into your lower abdomen. And then all the way out, nice and slowly. In through the nose and out through the nose. One more time, just in your own time. Deep breath in, nice and slow breath out. Very nice. Now from here, we're going to bring one leg in towards us a little bit. The foot towards the opposite buttock, the other foot comes on top. So you've got two options here. You can just bring the sole of the foot onto the ground, just on the other side, or you can come into Gomukhasana, or the half part of Gomukhasana. We're just sitting with both knees on top of each other. And then just relax, just put your hands on your knee. We'll do the same thing. So we're going to start breathing deeply in through the nose and out through the nose. We want to feel our stomach expand every time that we breathe in. If you want, you can put one hand on your stomach, two hands on your stomach, just connect with your baby. You can close the eyes again. Stay here, that's absolutely fine. If you want to go a little bit deeper, to Gomukh legs, cow face legs, if that makes any sense, then just bring your hands either onto the knees or you can bring them onto your stomach. Close your eyes, breathe in all the way. And slowly breathe out. Deep breaths in. Remember to really take our time on the out breath. It's just as important as the in breath. It activates our vagus nerve, which basically is responsible for activating our parasympathetic nervous system. That's the part of our nervous system that calms us down. So that's just creating this calm chemistry in our body that we want, no matter what happens. Tabletop pose, bringing the hands underneath our shoulders and the knees underneath our hips. I'm sorry if I over-explain for those who are very, very good at yoga, who've done it so often, but maybe you're a beginner and you just do it because you're not pregnant. So we just want to relax our head here, down in between our hands. And we start slowly arching our back. So you push your tailbone up towards the sky, towards the ceiling if you're inside, and then you look towards the front. Take a deep breath in and exhale as you drop the head and then round too much about how much you do this, just whatever's coming. And then inhale again and arch.
Maybe even look up if that's comfortable.
And then exhale and run. And then find your own rhythm here.
I say that a lot, but especially because you're pregnant, that is even more important. You just want to connect with your breath no matter what you're doing. So inhaling as you're arching,
exhaling as you're rounding your back.
And the head follows in whichever way is comfortable for you. And we'll try and not hold our breath at any point, because we're fine with that, but our fetus isn't. So we'll keep our breath nice and steady, no holding at the top, no holding at the bottom.
It's a steady stream of oxygen
coming into our body
and leaving our body.
Our buttocks towards our
heels, and if you need a little bit more space, you just might
bring your knees mat distance apart and then just sink down and try not to think about what you normally do in yoga and really go for it as you come down.
Just keep a little bit of space here, just bring your forehead onto the ground, and if you need more space, just stay here.
We won't stay here forever, but we're going to try and remind ourselves of the breath again.
So just like before,
deep breaths all the way in.
Whatever feels right. And on the next exhale, slowly round your back and come up.
And then we're going to make our way into a downward dog. So often referred to as a pose that you shouldn't do, but if you don't stay for long, that's absolutely fine. All things considered, and you'll know better and your doctor will know better. So we're going to tuck the toes under, hands firmly on the ground, on the mat, and we spread the fingers wide.
The feet about hip distance apart, if you want even further apart, so whatever's comfortable here, whatever gives you that nice feeling. And let yourself just sink into this pose. And take a deep breath in, raise the right leg, and on the exhale,
step the right foot forward. It doesn't matter where it lands. If it's somewhere here, that's absolutely fine. Grab hold of your ankle and reach it a little bit further forward, and then sink that back knee down. So not too much of a strain for your pelvic floor. So then from here, make sure that your right foot is on the outside of the right hand, so not too far back, so that you're protecting your knee. And then from here, inhale and raise the right arm. And create a lot of space here as well, so don't just go over here. Nice and spacious. Deep breath in. And breathe out all the way. I'm closing the eyes because of the sun. You can close the eyes as well. If it feels comfortable, you come onto the outer edge of the foot and you can push the knee a little bit out, but whatever is comfortable, we want to do. Deep breath in. Breathe out, which also means whatever isn't comfortable, we won't do. So from here, bring that neck back
and sink back down into child pose. Remind yourself
of those deep breaths. Just in any pose, we want to remind ourselves. And then we'll remind ourselves of that breath when it really matters.
Take a deep breath in, we exhale and come back
into Parvatasana, mountain pose, or downward dog.
Okay, and then from here again, deep breath in as we raise our left leg. And we exhale as we step that left foot on the outside of the left hand.
Again, take your time here, you're probably somewhere around here, that's absolutely fine. And we do the same thing we did on the right.
We're going to bring that back knee,
the left knee to the ground. And then we inhale and raise that right arm. Sorry, left arm.
Left arm goes up, look up.
Or if it's more comfortable, you just look down. So whatever doesn't strain your neck muscles here. Should be a comfortable pose, should be comfortable for you. And again, we can come onto the lateral edge of the foot if we want. Push the knee out a little bit further. Breathe out, bring that hand down, and come back into child's pose.
If you
you could be together here, knees apart, and you sink down, or really whatever works for you. So yoga is all about doing something, you can stay down there, doing something that is right for your body. It doesn't have to look like it looks with me or with anyone else that you've seen on Instagram or wherever. So just make sure that you're comfortable.
From here we come back up. Bring the knees together,
feet a little bit apart, tap the toes under,
and then from here we're going to walk forward. Let ourselves hang. So you can grab hold of your elbows here, and then just walk from side to side.
And here your legs are a little bit bent.
And from here, hands onto the knees, and slowly come up, rounding a little bit. Inhale,
raise the arms and the torso. Exhale, and bring the hands to your heart center. Good. Well, we're feeling fine. Hope you didn't come up too quickly. So now we bring the feet apart, wide stance here, toes turn out, then we're going to sink down, knees coming towards the toes, hips push forwards, with a nice and straight spine, we can hold on to our belly here if you want, we sink down, we can raise the arms again, bring them up here, but because it might be quite nice to have the hands here on the tummy, that is absolutely fine as well, as long as we're not rounding. Now, nice strong legs here. Arms can be up here, hands can be at the heart center. So there's no right or wrong, lots of different options. Good. And we breathe. And if you want to take a break, you can take a break. And now we're going to start engaging our pelvic floor. So this is what we're calling, well, it's exactly the same thing as engaging the pelvic floor. Our muladhara band, so our upward abdominal block. Just squeezing, letting go. As if we were going for a wee. That's exactly what we're doing. We're holding in the wee and then we're letting go. Good. From here, inhale and straighten the arms, straighten the legs. Exhale, bring the hands to your heart center. And then we're bringing the feet a little bit closer in. We're going to come into Malasana. This is the goddess pose, Utkatkonasana. And from here, Malasana, garland pose, we're coming down into a deep squat. So we can bring the hands onto the ground if that's more comfortable. You feel like you're losing your balance. Now try and find that balance here. If you need to, bring a hand behind you. If you're quite uncomfortable, bring your forearms to rest on your knees. And if you're down at the bottom, you can bring the hands to your heart center and you can use your elbows to push the knees towards the back. Nice, huh? I think so. So this is a really good one. And also, I think I might have, no, I didn't mention that. So as we were doing the cat-cow curls, the arched back and rounded back on all fours, this is one that's really, really good to do until the end, really. It can encourage proper positioning and makes your baby come down lower. So it's a really good thing to do. And in general, movements are really, really good when you're pregnant. So we're creating lots of positive neurotransmitters when you're moving. So feel free to move here if you like, if that's comfortable, rather than staying in pose. If you feel unbalanced, you can also just and you can keep your hands wherever it's comfortable for you. If you have a block or something to sit on, you can sit on something as well and make it a little bit easier. Now from here, deep breath in. Exhale, bring the hands down to the ground and then push yourself up and bring the heels behind your toes. And then just drop your head down and let your arms just go wherever. You can hold onto your elbows, you can grab hold of your wrists here, of your ankles, and then just relax. You need to bend the legs a little bit, that's fine. And then slowly bring our hands over to one foot. And we walk them over to the other side. And from here, step the feet a little bit further in. Bend your legs. Inhale and raise your arms and torso. exhale and bring the hands to your heart center. Feet step together and we'll come into Utkatasana. Utkat is actually fierce in Sanskrit, but this is also called the chair pose. So from here we're going to inhale and raise the arms. And as we exhale, we sink down into our knees. Just like in a squat, we want to shift the weight towards the back. You'll notice here, we're not coming forwards. Weight is on the heels. The arms are high. If it's a little bit too tricky to have the feet together, step them apart. And then make sure that you're tucking your tailbone under. And there's still a lot of space for baby. Now move in. In through the nose, out through the nose. Just never forgetting that it's all about the breath. Now from here, exhale and come into a forward fold. Don't worry about the hands, whether they're touching the ground or not. Just give yourself a little breathe as you're rounding the back a little bit, bending the legs if you need to, maybe even helping yourself out. Bringing your forearms onto the knees, onto the thighs, wherever you want to. Now from here, inhale, raise your arms, raise your torso. Exhale, bring the hands to your heart center. And then we'll step to the front of the mat and we'll keep our feet about hip distance apart. We want to keep our balance. As we're getting ready for giving birth, our body becomes just a little bit more, well, soft everywhere. So sometimes that messes with our balance. So we just want to make sure we're taking proper precautionary steps. Good. So take a deep breath in, raise the arms. And then exhale, bring the hands to your heart center. And rather than tipping down from the hip, keep a little bit of space here. And bring your hands to the ground. It doesn't matter where they are, even if they're a little bit in front, it's fine. Bend your legs. Hands firmly on the ground. And then we're going to step the right leg back. You'll notice that from before. We can walk the hands a little bit further back now. Then we bring that knee to the ground. We bring the top of the foot to the ground. Nice and gently, finding our balance, we'll raise the arms. If you find here that you're a little bit wobbly, rather than bringing the arms up, just see if this is helpful. If it's still a little bit wobbly, bring your hands down onto the ground and stay there. And look up. That feels comfortable. What we don't want to do is come backwards. We're stretching all of this already enough by being pregnant. And the further along you get, the more this gets stretched. So we don't want to add to that by adding a back bend here. So just nice and straight torso. And then take a deep breath in. Exhale, bring the hands down. And then let that left leg follow. And then from here, we're gonna do another cat stretch. Marjana. Inhale and arch, exhale and round your back. Inhaling all the way and exhaling all the way. Very nice. Now from here, tuck the toes under again and push the hips up, straighten the legs a little bit or a lot. You can bring the feet a little bit further apart, hands are apart anyway. Shoulder distance probably. Inhale, raise the right leg. Doesn't matter how high. This is not the time to challenge your body. And on the exhale, step that right foot on the outside of the hand. And again, don't worry if it doesn't land there. It's okay if it's here. You just grab hold of it and bring it a little bit further forward. It doesn't want to come all the way there. Just adjust the hand. Now back knee to the ground. And we inhale and raise the right arm. So we've done this one before. If that felt nice, we'll do it again. If not, you can stay exactly there as well. Okay, deep breath in. Exhale, bring the hand down. And then from here, back into Malasana. So we're going to sink the hips down. We're going to raise that back leg and bring the left knee forward. Easy. Very good. And if that wasn't easy and you're just making your way into the pose, don't worry, we're going to stay here for a little. Join us whenever you're ready. And again, your shoulders relaxed. What I meant was the elbows. I don't know where shoulders came from. So elbows, push gently against the knees. If you're somewhere here, that's fine too. Don't worry too much about it. And we breathe, enjoy. We can rock from side to side a little bit here. And then take a deep breath in. On the exhale, bring your hands down to the ground and push your hips up. And then bring your toes forward so that they're right in front of your heels. Bend your legs a little bit, round your back. Inhale as you come up. And exhale as you bring the hands to your heart center. So that was a very different version of Surya Namaskar, the sun salutation. Just a variation which is better for us if we're pregnant. And we're going to do the same thing again. So feet about hip distance apart or so. And then inhale and raise your arms. Look up if that's comfortable. And exhale, bring the hands to your heart center and slowly make your way down. Again, you can round here, that's absolutely fine. You can bend the legs. Bring the hands wherever it's comfortable for you. If they can be on the outside of the feet, that's great. But might be more balanced for you if you bring them in front. I'm going to drop the head for a little bit. And then inhale as you step your left leg towards the back. And then we can adjust the hands a little bit. We exhale and bring that back knee down, the top of the foot as well. And we really want to take our time here. So again, if we're a little bit wobbly, we just take our time and bring one forearm onto the bent leg. You maybe see if this is fine. You might be sitting there thinking, what is she on about? This is so easy. All right, if it is, then we just raise the arms and we can sink down to where it's comfortable. And also, hands can be together here. If the arms are nice and straight, we're still relaxing the shoulders. Otherwise, hands apart, that's easier. And we take nice and deep breaths in. We look up if that's comfortable. But we won't come into a back bend. So just nice and straight. We take a nice and deep breath in, last one here. And then we exhale and bring the hands down. And we slide that right foot back. And we're back in that tabletop pose. We can adjust here, bring the hands right underneath our shoulders again if they weren't. And then we inhale whenever we're ready and arch our back. And we exhale and bow. All the way in and all the way out. So our babies are really good this way. They are creating these positive neurotransmitters for us when we are moving. Nice, huh?
Yeah.
From here we tuck our toes under. Hands nice and firm, fingers spread wide. And we push back up into down. More gentler version of it. Don't go as deep as you normally would, just wherever you can go to. Inhale and raise your left leg. Exhale and step that left foot on the outside of the left hand. So maybe here, if that's too much, just wherever you'd like to be and adjust the hands, okay? Back knee to the ground, top of the foot to the ground. You'll notice this will get more and more difficult as you go along, so whatever feels right here. Inhale, raise your left arm, and if it's comfortable, look up, otherwise just look down or to the side. One more deep breath in here, and then we exhale, bring that hand down. Remember what's coming now, we'll tuck our back toes under, we're gonna raise that leg and push off and into Malasana. So deep squat. We're going to shift our weight from side to side if we want. We can find that we're quite comfortable staying here and not moving. Deep breaths, guys. Big smiles. And now from here, hands go to the ground. We push back up. And bring our toes in front of the heels. And then we inhale and raise our torso and arms. And we exhale and bring the hands to our heart center. Good. Two rounds of Surya Namaskar, sun salutation. Inhale again and raise your arms. And then exhale and fold forwards. maybe your heels want to come out a little bit too. Just see what works for you here. And one more time. It's a really good pose for pregnancy, as you might have guessed, because I do it a lot. And we'll just let ourselves get more and more comfortable. And from here, we're going to bring one hand behind us and sink down onto our buttocks. And then we come onto our back. We straighten the legs a little bit and grab hold of our feet here if we can. If not, just bring the knees down or hold onto your ankles, previously referred to as wrists. So wherever is comfortable for you, we're not going to stay for long, but we're going to be in happy baby and we're going to rock from side to side here a little bit. Good. And then from here, knees come down to the ground in a nice and gentle hip bridge. So not too much. Feet firmly onto the knees. Knees come down, feet come down onto the ground. And we're going to bring the hands onto the ground right next to us. Deep breath in, and then on the exhale, push your tailbone up nice and gently. Good. So stay nice and low. Think Pilates rather than yoga. And then engage your pelvic floor. So hold your Wii and then let go. Want to go a little bit higher, that's fine, but try not to overdo it here. Again, think this is not your usual yoga level if you're very advanced. Take another deep breath in and then exhale and come down. And slowly bring the knees in towards you. Just the knees more towards your armpits than towards your chest. Good. And then from here, left foot down onto the ground and we straighten the right leg. Don't worry if that leg isn't entirely straight. You just want to raise the leg. That's really good for your GABA levels, gamma amino butyric acid. So another really good positive neurotransmitter. Just let yourself lie here. If you want to, you can open your palms to the ceiling. On the next exhale, bend the leg and bring it down. And then inhale as you raise your left leg. Just let it rest there for a little bit. Deep breaths in and deep breaths out. And the next exhale, bring it back down. And because I'm facing this way, I'm going to turn onto the right side, but you make sure you come onto the left side of your body, okay? And use your left arm as a cushion for your head, so you're nice and comfortable here. Right hand can just be in front of you here to support you a little bit. And if you want to close your eyes, we'll take every opportunity to work with our breath here. So feel that breath go all the way into your body and all the way out. And on the next exhale, slowly push into that right hand, come up to seated. And I would suggest that you come into Shukasana, into the easy pose, happy pose, which basically means you can adjust to wherever you want. So cross leg here, or a little bit wider, just depends on how open your hips are. So find something that works for you, and also try not to slouch too much here. You can have space here, but that doesn't mean that you have to round the shoulders forwards. In fact, this is what we want to work on now. We want to come into reverse namaste. I'll demonstrate the whole thing first and I'll turn around for that. But don't worry if this is a little bit too much for you. We're going to bring the tops of the hands in between our shoulder blades and then bring our palms together and push the elbows towards the back. If you're an experienced yogi, that will not be a problem for you, but if you're new to this, desk job and it's all a little bit much for you and you're a bit tight in this area anyway, then maybe just hold on to your forearms like that. Squeeze your shoulder blades and push the elbows towards the back. So that's all it is. Keep that up and see what works for you here. So if full reverse namaste is not working for you, that's absolutely fine. You'll see here, I'm currently in reverse namaste. You'll see that I'm pushing the shoulder blades towards each other, pushing the shoulders away. From
me and towards the back. I'm pushing the elbows towards the back as well. And if I do a little bit less than that and I hold on to my forearms or to my elbows, then I can do exactly the same thing. I can squeeze my shoulder blades and I can push the elbows towards the back. So it doesn't really matter what happens with the hands so much, as long as we're focusing on this nice chest opening. And then you can close the eyes. We'll hold this for two more breaths. Again, no need to rush. I'm not going to tell you when to breathe. That's something you just need to do by yourself, just in your own time. Good. And then from here, we slowly release. Bring the hands onto our knees. And then from here, we're going to a tiny little twist. We're going to bring our left hand on top of the right knee. That right hand can come behind us, so really close towards us, where our tailbone is. That's where we want it, because that way we're nice and straight. We want to make sure that we're aligning ourselves here. So the shoulders are over our hips. And from here, we're gently turning. We'll take a deep breath in. And we're pushing our shoulder towards the back. So don't think that you want to twist here. This is more about the upper body. And nice and gently as well. So as we're pregnant, we get a little bit more flexible because everything in our body softens. We don't want to work on flexibility here. We just want to make sure we're using our posture here right, because as we're getting bigger, our body compensates for that, and we don't want to slouch forward. Turn your head towards the back. If that's comfortable, it will look beyond your right shoulder here. And then take a last deep breath in, and on the exhale, slowly come back towards the front. Hands back. If you want to, you can try and bring yourself on the other side. So might feel a little bit strange because we naturally have one side that works a little bit better. So one foot is always out when we're cross-legged. So straight spine, relax the shoulders, and then we're going to bring the right hand on top of the left knee. Left hand behind us, close to our tailbone. Straighten our spine. We take a deep breath in. We smile, and then we exhale and we turn gently, making sure that twist comes from our upper shoulders, not upper body, it's also upper body, and not from our belly. This is not for the lower back here, we normally do when we're doing a seated twist. Very nice. On the next exhale, slowly come back. And from here, we're going to straighten the right leg. We'll keep that left leg where it is, so you can bring the sole of the foot in towards your thigh. Flex our foot. Oh, my feet aren't too dirty right now. And then from here, just bring your hands, you can interlock your hands, and bring them underneath your knee. And allow yourself to just come forward. So we don't want to hinge forward here, that's going to put, going to make sure we have enough space here, basically. So don't worry too much about bringing the shoulders forward here, and you can also just drop the head. If it feels nice, you can come a little bit further forwards, but that's completely optional. What we don't want to do is reach the shoulders too far forwards. It's fine to just drop them and relax them, but not too far forward. So if this feels like a strain for you, it probably is. You can hold on to your ankle instead. Hands here means that you're comfortably able to hold on to the foot. If your hands are somewhere here, just hold on a little bit higher, okay? Now from here, slowly roll up. We're gonna bring our left hand behind us and then shift the weight onto that bent leg and push the hips up and reach that arm up. Don't worry about how high you're going. Again, you don't want to come into a back bend, so stay lower, okay? And take a deep breath in and exhale as you come down. We straighten our left leg and we bring the right foot in towards us. Flex your toes. Again, hands can interlock underneath our knee and we slowly come forward. There's a lot of space, it doesn't matter how low you are. So it's probably not possible for you, because you want to keep that space here to actually hold on, depending on how far you are.
Just relax.
And we reconnect with our breath here, I hope. Very aware of how we're breathing. Also fine to just raise the hips a little bit, it doesn't have to be all the way there. Whatever feels right, whenever you are in the pose that you like, breathe in all the way, out all the way, and then exhale, you come down again. Straighten that leg, and we're going to bring the legs a little bit further apart. See what works here for you, what is comfortable, what isn't, and we slowly make our way down. Again, you can round your shoulders. If you're very flexible, you might be able to bring your forearms onto the ground, drop the head here. Just relax your body. That's what it's all about, just relaxing, breathing, feeling what's going on inside of us. That's just the most important thing, really, just listening to your body, especially when you're pregnant.
Take a deep breath in,
breathe out, and on the next inhale, we'll slowly bring the hands back onto the grass, and we'll walk them closer in towards us coming up.
Good, very nice. We'll come back into Shukasana or into any comfortable position. Actually, just to change it a little bit, we can sit on our heels.
If that's comfortable for you, great. If it isn't, come back into a cross-legged position,
okay?
And now I've got my favorite part for you. So this is something that I find is wonderful for everyone because it basically calms your system. But especially when you're pregnant, this is something that you just need to know. This is the most important thing, not the movements, but the breath. Because with this breath, Brahmi Pranayama, so you might know it from another video that I've posted, we're essentially giving our body all of those happy hormones that we need to be calm, we need to be relaxed, that our body is getting after we've given birth anyway. So we don't have to worry about the afterwards, that's just something that's happening automatically. But as we're in labor, we might be a little bit panicky, we might forget about our breath. So for all of this, it just helps us to remind ourselves of the breath and to remind ourselves that what is happening to us, the stress hormones that we're creating, are being created in our body. That's an actual physical thing that happens, and we want to counter them by calming our body, and that's something that happens in our body through our breath. So all we need to do is take deep breaths in and deep breaths out. So we did that at the beginning, but we can activate the vagus nerve that I mentioned at the beginning in an even faster manner by also engaging our vocal cords. So what we're going to do now is not om chanting, you can do that as well, but we want to do something else. We want to just hum out and then hum in. And what that does is it creates continued vibrations. So with om, we have that deep breath in where we're not actually using the vibrations in our head that then travel down our spinal cord, etc. So what we want to do is keep those up. We'll start by practicing the humming in. So this is Brahmari Pranayam, the humming bee. And humming in, I think humming out is not going to be a problem for anyone, so I'm not going to worry about that. But humming in can be, because we're not creating sound by breathing in. In most languages, we're creating sound by breathing out, just like that. So, we're going to take a deep breath in and open our mouth. And we might want to think of a shocking situation or a situation in which we were surprised and we were going like, oh, my surprise birthday party, or something like that. So we're going to put one hand on our stomach, one on our chest, and we're going to go, very good. And we'll do that again. Deep breath in. It's a tiny little sound. Doesn't matter how that sounds. You can do it one after the other. You can do a lot of those. You might think that sounds awful. What is she doing? What am I doing? It doesn't matter how it sounds. We're now going to close our mouth and do the same thing. So we'll go
it's a little bit too early for that, and just keep opening the mouth. Maybe prolong that sound a little bit. So either or same with the mouth open. And don't think too much about it, because it will come completely naturally to you after a little while. So again, maybe mouth closed now. Good. And then maybe just bring your hands back down, relax them. You can bring them into Gyan Mudra, bring the thumb and forefingertip together. And then just go. So just relaxing on the out breath and allow yourself to create some sound. Doesn't matter how you're sounding, no one's here to hear you. No one's here to hear me out. Okay, so. And then, once we keep doing what you're doing right now, once we've done that for a little bit longer, we might notice that this becomes more natural. And we become a little bit more into that sound. It becomes more natural for our body, it becomes more natural for us to do this. And that's the point where we start think of a bee and that sound that a bee is making. So we'll go, rather than going, we'll just relax everything. Even our mouth and our tongue is completely relaxed. And we just go, you'll feel them in your tongue, in your lips, in your nose. So we'll do this a little bit more, just breathing in, and then start with the humming out, because that's easier. So deep breath in. And then immediately hum in. Find a rhythm here, and don't worry about that in hum. It's going to be much higher pitched, it's going to be a slightly less strong sound, and it's going to be less long, and all of that is completely fine. We want that out breath to be longer, because that activates our vagus nerve. Then we want to keep those vibrations up. Okay, so now one more thing. San Mukhi Mudra. The mudra is a hand gesture, just like Yan Mudra is a hand gesture, and this one helps us to turn our senses inwards. It's very easy. We're going to use that little bit of cartilage here. We're going to press on it with our thumb. So I'm going to do one hand first, just to show you. Just press the fingers wherever it's comfortable. And close off the ears and eyes. We'll do about 5 rounds of that. Don't worry, once you're ready, deep breath in, hum out, and then in, out 5 times. Palms of the hands in touch with your thighs. Roll the shoulders forwards, up and towards the back, and then slide them down. Give yourself a smile. Deep breath in, exhale through the mouth. And one more time, in through the nose. And then let your breath return to normal. Just nice and deep breaths, in through the nose, out through the nose. Eyes are closed. Notice how you're feeling. And when you're ready, open your eyes. I hope you've enjoyed that video. One last thing before I say goodbye. which we just did, is also very good against headaches and against migraines. So if you suffer from those, this is a really good way to get out of the habit of using painkillers. So you don't even need paracetamol if you've got Brahmi Pranayam. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe to our channel. And I hope I'll see you again very, very soon. Bye!